voice for men cried, and you heard it. His for men cried, and you heard. His for men cried, and you heard. His for men cried, and you heard. And you heard this poor man cry, 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 and you heard this poor man cry. This poor man cry, and you heard. 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 This poor man cry. This poor man cried, and you heard. 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 This poor man cried. Poor man cried, and you heard. This 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 poor man cried, and you heard.
Father, we bless you today. We magnify you, oh God. We glorify you, God. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Just keep, don't cut my music on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Glory, we thank you, Father. And we bless you, oh God. We magnify your name. We thank you, oh God, for hearing us. We thank you, oh God, for seeing about us. We thank you, God, for responding to our cry. Hallelujah, for hearing our cry, for responding to our cry. We thank you, oh God, that you didn't leave us.
Hallelujah.
We thank you, God, that you didn't turn a deaf ear toward us. And we bless your name today. We thank you, oh God, that you save us. We thank you, oh God, that you rescue us. God, that you deliver us, oh God. Hallelujah. And we bless your name. And we give you the praise and the honor. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. You can turn it down. Hallelujah. You can turn it down. Glory. Turn it off for now. For now. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Right there. That's good. I can still hear it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It's the sound of intercession. It's the sound. You may be seated. It's the sound of intercession. Hallelujah. A sound. Glory to God. And it definitely helps to set the atmosphere. Glory to God. I want to stay in that vein, and I don't think I'll be before you long as it relates to what this is. Because I want to release this word. Amen. And so as you all begin to sing, amen, about hearing God, number one, thank God for the angels of this house, amen, to everyone. Thank God, amen. But as prophets begin to release, I'm like, right there, amen, right there. Glory to God. I went to get the mic. I was like, no, this ain't for some, but this for prophets. Hallelujah. Glory to God, because, amen, we need to train our ear to hear our own. Glory to God. And it's not that other people cannot speak, amen, but he definitely speaks to those who, amen, that he set in the place. Glory to God. So we need to, like I said the other night on Friday, that when I called my son, amen, though he was way down on the other end of the field, he heard me. Glory to God. We're going to stick right there with that hearing. He heard me, amen, and he made a U-turn and responded, amen, to my voice. Glory to God. So we're going to sit there for a minute, amen, on that hearing. Glory to God. But I just want to speak this, amen, in this atmosphere. As God began to speak, amen, began to just release. Glory to God. Thank God for the psalmist woman of God. Amen. We thank you for your voice. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. I saw that you were due to speak, but amen. We have to follow the Holy Ghost and God work that thing out. Glory to God. You come on up, Lord. I'm like, Jesus, do it, God. I say, glory. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I love it. Amen. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit. Glory to God, it overrides. Amen. I'm like, go get the flag, go get the mic. Glory, we tapping in. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So I thank God, amen, that we respond to his presence, amen, and what he's wanting to do. Glory to God. Hallelujah. My son London, wave your hand, amen. Pastor Vaughn came in from Dayton this morning, amen. So I thank God for him as well. But listen, I want to jump in here. I don't like breaking it up. Glory. So one of the things I do want to reiterate, amen, something that Pastor Gary said on yesterday, because we have to understand in the apostolic and prophetic house, amen, we can come up with things, and it's good, amen, to have some things written out. But he gave and released, amen, that apostolic word. Glory to God. And so I want to reiterate that, because it triggers some things of what God had already spoken to me. So I want to go on record saying yes and amen. And one of the things that does is we recorded it. I'm going to release this word, amen, to apostles and prophets. But what this does is we have to understand one of the things that the Bible says, where there's two or three witnesses, that word is established. Why am I repeating this word? Amen. One of the things that I teach a lot of times, when you hear it that second time, it literally is established.
Okay. Come on now.
Okay. It's established.
Amen.
And so when you have a witness to it, it's established. Amen. And so here's the thing to understand, because a lot of times we say, well, there's two witnesses. Amen. And you take two or three witnesses, that thing is done. We typically take that and we relate that to, you know, well, I said this and then they said it too. Take a witness with you. But when you study that out, you're talking about times and seasons. Amen. Times and seasons. So what that looks like is this is how, when we're looking at calendar time, amen, and we start talking about, here's a reset, amen, God is doing a new thing, and here's a new time, here's a new moon, amen, he's restoring something, he's doing a new thing, amen. So one of the things how this looks like, amen, when you study that out, is that you have someone that's reporting from one side, amen, that they saw a new moon. Y'all know, when we went last night, I was like, look at that moon, it was a full moon. And if you ever call somebody and say, did y'all see the moon from, can you see it from where y'all live? Because, I mean, I'm just trying to see it. We're looking at the same moon. And so what that is, back when they were using the calendar and starting over, amen, one of the things that they did was they reported the new moon.
Mercy.
We do not use, amen, the body, a Gregorian calendar. Amen. And so one of the things is, it is a lunar system. When you're looking at Bible times, it is based, amen, on a lunar system, not a solar system. It is based on moons, amen. It is based on the spotting of the moon, the witnessing of a moon. So you would have somebody, and I'm just going to say Kentucky, that saw that new moon last night, amen, and think it not strange that God is doing a new thing, amen. And so you would have someone, the first witness would come in to the court, amen, and they would report that they had seen a new moon. Amen. They witnessed a new moon.
Yes.
Amen. So they would come in and they record it. Somebody would come in from the other side. Another side of town, from the other side, amen, from Georgia. So I'm just kind of being a little exact. But they would come in and report there's a new moon. That's the second witness. Mm. So what it did is it said, listen, the first witness saw the new moon, the new beginning, amen, a new time. And so now here's the other witness, the second witness to come in and say, yes, I saw the new moon. So it's recorded. You got two witnesses, and now it's established that that is the beginning of the month. It's now established that that's the beginning of time. Amen. We get to start over. Amen. And here's the new month right in here.
Amen.
When they saw the full moon. What am I saying? Because what he began to release yesterday, he is one of the first, I'm going to say the first witness. Amen. It's not that nothing's ever been said in here. I don't want to leave that. Amen. But what he said, I'm a second witness to what he said.
All right.
Amen.
So what that does is, amen, it establishes that thing in the house. What that does is it establishes what God is wanting to do. Amen. On the second witness, that thing is established. Amen. So I come to, amen. Here's the word that was released to say, for I have drawn you here, for you have not come on your own, for I have a reason and I have a purpose. Not that yours is not important. This is what was released yesterday. But there is something that I must do. This is the Lord talking.
Yes.
He said, for I hear, there's that word here. For I hear the cry from the heart of everyone, and there's something that says, I'm still hungry.
Mercy.
Says, I want to know, I want you to know that I hear the voice of that hunger. And this day, I will begin to equip those that have a hunger in many different ways. Says, some I shall empower, others I will anoint, but it is for you to know.
Wow. Amen.
That the Lord, here's the part, has heard your cry.
Amen.
It has brought you into one place in one accord. And that same kind of power that I released on Pentecost, I'm going to release in smaller ways unto you to do what? A new thing. Mm. A new work in you, because I have called you to do greater things that you know not of. There shall be more to come, but I shall prepare you. And I will make you ready if thou will follow in Isaiah's steps and say, here am I, Lord. Send me. He said, I will send you. This is the word of the Lord that was released yesterday. But when he began to talk about, I hear you. And I said, oh my God. And then this is what they said. He said, I hear you and I hear. And he said, I've heard your cry. And so he said, I've heard that hunger. Amen. Like more of you, God. We should never, ever get tired of saying, God, I want more of you.
Yes.
But the part that I want to focus on, he said, I heard you. With that being said, I said, oh my God, here's the thing, that from this place he hears us. From this place, amen, our cries go up to him and he responds. Turn to Deuteronomy 6, chapter 6. Leviticus chapter 6. Deuteronomy 6. Hallelujah. Deuteronomy 6, real quick, here's the lesson, here's the thought. Amen. It is, let me see. Yep, Deuteronomy 6. Hallelujah. This is what it says. I'm going to read down to verse 5. Let's see. Glory to God. Nope, I'm going to read verse 7. Verse 6, amen. Verse Deuteronomy 6. 1 through 7. It says, now this is the commandment, the statutes, and the ordinances which the Lord your God commanded to teach you, that ye might do them in the land whither ye go over to possess it, that thou mightest fear the Lord thy God to keep all his statutes and his commandments which I command thee, thou and thy son, and thy son's son, all your grandchildren, all the days of thy life. And that thy days may be prolonged. Here's the part. Here we go with this hearing. Hear, therefore, O Israel, and observe to do it, that it may be well with thee, and that ye may increase mightily, as the Lord thy God of thy fathers has promised unto thee, a land flowing with milk and honey. Here's the part here. This part, when you get to verse 6, I'm going to spell it for you. This is the part where the Jewish is called the Shema.
Shema.
The Shema. And it says this. It's in Deuteronomy. The Shema contains, listen, Deuteronomy 6, 4, and 5. It's the Shema. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy might. And these words which I command thee this day shall be upon thy heart. And thou shalt teach them diligently unto thy children, and thou shalt talk of them when thou sittest in the house, and when thou walkest by the way, and when thou liest down, and when thou risest up. Deuteronomy 6, 4 and 5 is the Shema. And one of the things the Lord began to show me with this, he said it changes, amen. Definitely one of the ways that it changes, amen, our perspective on how we pray. One of the things that this is, it's precious to the Jewish people, amen. And so one of the things amongst the Jewish people is that this is literally the last dying words. They hope to be their last dying words, amen, of a Jew. That when they leave here, they want their last words to be, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one." And one of the things that they're saying, listen, we serve one God.
Come on.
One God. Remember that we serve one God. Because they were amongst people, amen, that serve several gods. So they're saying right in here, remember that we're serving only one God. Amen. And so it says, thou shalt love the Lord thy God. Here they put an emphasis on the fact that God is, he's our Lord. Amen. He's our Lord. And so when you begin to look at that, amen, the Bible says, blessed is the nation whose Lord is God. Not other gods, Almighty God. Amen. So here's a reminder that we're serving one God. But I want to focus on this here. Here in the Hebrew, when you look at that, amen, and the reason I'm giving you that, because listen, when you begin to study these words out, it is good. Nobody's trying to, you know, oh, you know, who cares about all the theology? No, when you start looking at this, when you look at it in its original, it is, let me give this to you. I believe it's Strong's number H808085. When you look at it, I'm giving that to you. Yes, it is. Okay, it's H. 8085. Why is that important? Because we know our words, amen. Sometimes in English, it's like, okay, did you hear me? Yeah, I heard you. It takes on a different meaning when you begin to study, amen, and it's in its origin. When you begin to study in context, amen, and what it really means. It doesn't just mean like, okay, yeah, here's something, amen, and then I just keep it moving. Amen. It has a different context, amen. And so what it says is the Shema. He Shema's us. So when we begin to pray, we pray now understanding the Shema. And so I'll go a little bit further in that. That, yeah, I prayed, and he didn't answer. He said, no. One of the things that he showed me, he said, now we got a lot of mamas in here and daddies. I ain't discounting you. But some about us mamas, if five babies start crying in here. I just asked Pastor, I said, is that Olivia? He's like, nah, that ain't nothing. Then he had to look up. That Olivia. Like, is that Olivia back there? Nope. Here's the thing. Because you can set 20 babies in the room. Let one baby go off. Amen. And the mama's going to get still a little bit. Wait for that second light. Yep. Amen.
All right.
The right mama's going to respond to the cry.
Yes.
And so because you know, number one, mine is sleep. That's number one. Show ain't mine. But we know and we understand and we hear. We have recorded and have programmed the cry of our children. Amen. It could be a bunch of babies in here. And we will respond. The right mama is going to respond to the right baby. And the mama say, amen. Amen. You're not going to have five mamas getting up like, oh, I thought that was my baby. Absolutely. There's no mistake that that's not my baby. Why am I saying this? Because when we hear the cry,
come on now.
The thing with the Shema is, not only did I hear it, but I responded to it.
Yes. Yes.
Not only did I take it in, but I responded. Amen. And so the purpose is to actually do something about that cry. You can hold the mother's baby, amen. But when and people are doing that, give back to his mama. Because can't nobody give to his mama. And you, oh, can I hold him? Yeah, you can hold him. Some days they give him here. We do that with our husbands. Amen. They can sit there and coochie-coo them babies. Amen. They fine. But when they go to really cry, they say, give them here. They say, go to your mama. They give it up because on their mamas, I'm telling you, I'm not negating the daddy. There's something that, amen, that we respond to in that cry. Amen.
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 All right. Amen. So when we're praying, there's an expectation that not only did he hear, amen, but he is coming to respond. This is what Shema is, that he's coming to respond. The word of the Lord is that I hear you. I'm not just like, that's cool. They praying today. No, the very intent of God, this is what we want to leave knowing, is to respond, amen, with a purpose with in mind to actually answer that cry, to bring a resolve to that prayer. Amen. And so one of the things here is that this is what Shema means. It's just in the simplest terms. Amen. It means to hear. When you look at that, to hear, it's at 785 times. So when you're looking at words such as hear and hearken, obey, publish, understand, show and sound and declare, that's Shema. It means to listen to the cry. It means to obey. It means to hear, to perceive by ear. It means to hear of or concerning. It means to hear, amen, to hear with intention or interest. And so God just don't let us sit there and pray and he's not intensively listening to respond to that cry.
Come on now.
One of the things that we have to understand in prayer is, number one, we pray God's word. You say, I don't know how to pray, really. I don't have the words. Here's one of the things that I've been saying for years, been promoting for years. Amen. Psalmist promotes it, a promise book. A simple promise book. Amen. Because when you're devoid of words, it's like, well, I don't have all the words. I'm going to give him back, amen, what is written.
Right.
Even Jesus did that and said, it is written. Amen. And so here's the law of God. Here's the very things of God. And so if you don't know, well, I really don't have, I don't know how to pray per se. Amen. Let me say this to you. Number one, get out of your emotions.
All right.
Get out of the emotions. Because the emotions will make you, oh God, I'm tired. I'm just tired. No. It's not that you don't acknowledge that. But I'm going to give him his word. Amen. God,
amen.
Your joy is my strength. Amen.
All right.
And so he begins to respond to that. Amen. And that says, listen, I got to come and do something. I'm coming to rescue. Amen. His ear is not, he's not deaf. Amen. So when we're praying, we got to get out of the emotion of it.
Yeah.
We have to get out of that place, amen, where we just, every time we come, amen, there's a whine, there's a hopelessness, amen. And so what I'm saying, again, we're not acknowledging the emotion, but guess what? I need to put the word of God in the atmosphere to give him something to respond to. Yes, he knows our hearts. The Bible lets us know he knows the very intent of the thought of our heart. Amen. But when I begin to pray, I actually take a promise book. I actually take the word of God because he's going to respond to it. And his word will not go up unfulfilled. It won't come back down unfulfilled. It's literally going to fulfill. It's going to accomplish the very place of where we're sitting. So I get the word of God. And sometimes people feel like, oh no, I just got to flow out my heart. Listen, even David said, my heart is noisy. It's making a bunch of noise, and I'm telling you, if you ever hit, you come out between a rock and a hard place, my back up against the wall, and if you're not careful, if I'm not careful, we'll begin to cry out of a place, amen, where our soul is wounded. We'll begin to cry out of a place, amen, where we'll start praying, God, get them. God, you see they doing something bad to me. And we'll start praying, sick of God, they hurt me. We'll pray out of a wounded place. If you don't train yourself, and we don't train ourselves to go to the word of God, many are the afflictions of the righteous.
Yes. Teaching.
Yes. So why in the world? Oh, God. Okay. I told somebody, I said, listen, honey, if I never release the prophetic word, if me releasing the prophetic word was predicated on how folk dog me, baby, my mouth would never open.
All right.
Come on.
God, they said something. They said something. One of them called me Lord Jesus. I heard a rocoton I was saying, God, did you just call me with this foolishness?
All right.
Immediately. Rosaya. I'm listening, baby. Go ahead. Rocotorababa. Oh yeah, God. Because guess what? Gotta take self out of it.
All right.
Gotta tell people, listen.
Yeah.
are.
Right.
Everybody had grown up to this place. Everybody don't know, amen, how to go pray and go sit down somewhere. Amen. So there are folks that walk up on you crazy. And that's at the time when you got to say, God, Lord, have mercy. Help me grow up.
Amen.
All right.
In that moment.
Yes.
And so we're not praying, amen, because our soul, I'm telling you, we don't say, I need a word. I need a word right in here. I got to find the word. Why is this promise book so important? I didn't promote it, folks, buying this book. I don't get nothing from it because she must get a kickback. If I did, it's still going to bless you, but I don't.
All right. All right.
It's called So That's in the Bible. With a question mark. So that's in the Bible? Y'all buy it. Remember the big old promise book. It's about like yellow pages. What does that do? That allows you to look up certain words to say, I need to find something on children. Find something on faith. What is the word saying on this? What does the word say, amen, about finances, about marriage? And you can look those scriptures up and begin to pray them, amen, and declare them, amen, amen, and confess them over your life.
Okay.
Stop saying if it ain't one thing, it's another. Amen. Because all you did was call on another.
Come on now.
All right.
Stop saying when it rains, it pours. Because some rain, amen, ain't good rain.
Amen.
All right.
Amen.
All that torrential rain, amen. Stop. Oh, when it rains, it pours. Oh, God. Oh, Lord, I just, if I went for bad luck, I wouldn't have none. Stop saying. We got to watch what comes out of our mouths.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Amen. We have to actually monitor what comes out of our mouths. And so if you're not in that place, I'm telling you, start training yourself. I'm going to get this word. I ain't saying nothing shy of this word. I'm staying straight to the word because it's that word, amen. Not only does it keep us, but he is responding to it.
Yes. Amen.
So we don't go as, God said, enough of that.
All right.
Enough of talking out the situation. Because
mm-hmm. Yes.
We talk about the situation. If King David said, Lord, even Jesus, listen, look here, if that cup, can that cup please bypass me? Please, I'm good on that cup.
All right.
Nevertheless, whoo, Jesus, what am I saying? We cannot go to God with all that emotion. Your soul, amen. Your will, our will, because it's his will that's done. Our will, our mind. How many of us say, I got the mind of, whoo. Stop saying I should have followed my first mind because you ain't got but one.
All right.
If you do got two, let us know.
Amen.
And I think you're going to come down to one.
All right.
Because we're going to deliver you from that second mind. Amen. That's a little bit of skills, that little bipolar schizophrenic stuff going on. We laughing, but folks said I should have followed my first mind. No, I should have been obedient to the Holy Ghost for this call.
All right. All right.
That's what I should have done. You ain't got two minds. If you feel like you do. Amen. Simple gonna get loose today. We're gonna run her up out of here in Jesus' name. Y'all playing. I'm for real. And so seriously, we come to God with wounded souls, our mind, that second mind, amen, that intellect, because some of us have figured it out and this is what it should look like and be like by now.
Amen.
Amen. And that imagination. Just come with the word of God. Hallelujah. Wake up. In the natural. Wake up. Hallelujah. And so here's the thing. Come with the word of God.
Amen.
With the word of God. And he hears us. Listen, I'm going to go a little further on this Shema. It says to hear. Listen at this. To understand language. It means to give, to listen to give heed to consent, to agree. To yield, this is what it means. To hear, I love this, of a judicial case. A judicial case. So here's the law of God. Listen, here's the things that we get into. Here's the very law of God. I'm going to hear this thing that's trying to arrest you. Here's this accusation that's coming against you. He's hearing judicial cases. Amen.
Help us, you teaching.
So he's not just listening like, okay. But here's the thing, as accusations that come that he's listening to, that he's responding to, amen. It means to be heard. It means to give regard. It means to cause to hear. It means to proclaim. This is the Shema. One of the things, amen, in scripture that you will find in the scripture, amen, I believe it's Leah that did not, she said, God has heard that I'm unloved. He has heard that I'm unloved. So when she named the child, really what she named him, I believe it was Shema. So when you look at that, the very root word means heard. When you look at that, so he didn't just listen. He did not just hear her cry. He responded to her, amen, and opened up her womb.
God.
He responded to that. So there's several scriptures, amen, where he literally heard and he delivered.
Yes.
All right.
And so when we're praying to God, when we're praying his word, there's an expectation that you will not leave me here. There's an expectation that I'm not going to sit here for long. There's an expectation, amen, that he's turning this situation around. Wake up. That he's turning the situation around. There's an expectation, amen, that what I presented to him, his word, he's going to honor it.
All right.
Praise God.
Amen. So when I come, amen, it says this, and I'm going to go back to this word. Several scriptures. If y'all just Google, you can just Google. If you Google it, Strong's H8085. There are several references because we have to begin to study this. I said, we're going to be long.
Amen.
We have to begin to study this out ourselves. Listen at this. When Abraham heard, amen, a lot of scriptures, amen. Even if it's, I'm going to give you a few of these scriptures. Amen. In Genesis, it talks about hearkening. It says that Abraham hearkened to the voice of Sarai. He shamaed. He responded. He did, amen. He listened with the intent to fix it, to respond to it. The very cry of her. There are so many things listed. Genesis 17 and 20. As for Ishmael, this is what the scripture said. I have heard thee. I have shamaed thee. Behold, I have blessed him. Y'all know the story of Ishmael and Israel? Oh, go put her out. Listen, your gal wife, the baby doing too much. She got to go. Now, you was your idea, Lil Sarah.
Come on.
Girl doing too much. She flying this little baby. Listen, I ain't finna do this every day. She all in there making pancakes and lemon bread. Her aunt, little ish, she got to go.
All right.
Come on, ladies. Come on. Get that Sarah, you know.
Amen.
Yes. Be gone. And so now the scripture lets us know he's sitting over yonder crying. The scripture says, as for Ishmael, I have what? Shamaed thee. Behold, I have blessed him and will make him fruitful and will multiply him exceedingly. Amen. 12 princes shall beget, he shall beget, and I will make him a great nation. Why am I saying that? Amen. Because now he was once this, and now he's like he's put out. And some of us have been put out. Amen. You was the one in some people's eyes, and so now you over there. And God said, listen, I'm shamaing you.
All
right. I'm hearing your cry. Amen. Because some of us have been on the other side of the desert. Amen. Like, God, oh my God, I was the firstborn. I was this. I was destined to this. He said, no, I should mind your cry in this hour. I am hearing you. I'm hearing the hunger. I'm hearing you want to go more farther. I'm hearing what it is that God is wanting to do. He said, I'm actually listening to rescue. I'm listening to respond. I'm listening to change. I'm listening to bring you out. I'm listening to bless you. I'm listening to multiply you. Your cry is not in vain. Your prayer is not in vain. He said, I'm actually listening, amen, to raise you up in this hour.
Yes.
He shamaned us. So when we pray, because we say, I gave it over to love.
Listen.
All them leaving out.
Lord Jesus.
There are some songs, can I tell you?
Amen.
Don't match scripture.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
They ain't scripture.
Yeah.
Can I really be honest with you? They was getting on over crossing to the Jordan. They were slave GPS songs.
Yeah.
Come on now.
All right.
Amen.
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 Before there was a GPS, the old folks sang a song.
Amen.
In that great getting up morning, Valuel, Valuel, in that great. We talked about two things already crossing over, and then they were giving signal, amen, yeah, as to which way to go down by the river. And we just studied this. They not gospel.
My God,
right. Come on now. Help us.
Amen.
They are GPS. They are salt. They are maps in the air.
Amen.
They told us, listen, when that sun come up, run in the run, baby, run in the direction of the sun. And so we sing that with an expectation, and I'm telling you, they taught us. We come down with them songs. I'm from Texas, okay? Amen. Them the songs that we sing. I'm gonna say we. They ain't seen them in Florida. But they was them songs, amen, that we really thought we were singing the gospel.
Amen.
All right.
And we were not singing the gospel. Why am I saying that? Because we're singing the thing that's trained and conditioned our mind to think that we're actually singing gospel songs, and they do not, amen, match scripture anywhere.
Right.
And so we've been taught, amen, well, I probably left it there, and I, or we'll say, well, I did that, I just, it is what it is. Then you pray without an expectation.
Come on,
I expect God to fulfill his word.
Right. Yes.
I didn't just leave it there. No, listen, can I tell you something? Say, it stayed there. I left it there. Absolutely not. That thing went up to heaven.
Come on now.
The Bible let me know. I didn't just leave. I left it there. We tries to say, listen, I didn't worry about it. No, I'm not worried about it. But I just, it's like, oh, well, whatever it is, what it is. I'm so used to. Stop making adjustments and provisions to be out of stuff that's out of whack and not in conjunction with God's word.
My God. That's good.
And so here's the thing. I'm praying with an expectation. When I pray, amen, his word, Lord have mercy, you're going to fulfill that thing. You have actually heard me. Amen. You have heard the condition. You have heard my cry. Amen. And I expect you to fulfill that word.
Yes, yes.
And so no man has taught me, amen, to just walk off and walk out in the sun and it is what it is. And, you know, we done been in all these kinesthetics and I'm going to turn my back. Amen. Listen, I'm going to pray this word and I'm going to sit right here and I'm going to watch God perform it. Amen. I'm not going to be intoxicated. I'm not going to act like I'm sedated because I'm fearful of what ain't going to happen. It's going to happen. If I absolutely declare that thing and it is the will of God concerning me, his word, amen, I'm putting everything on it. It's going to happen. He heard me. Glory to God. He shamas me and I got an expectation that he's going to deliver.
Yes.
Yes.
So we're not praying out of that soulless realm. We're not praying, amen, out of our tears, amen. We're not praying out of that. Several scriptures, Lord have mercy, can't even get out of Genesis, amen, without these scriptures, amen. Glory to God, just pop it up. This is what it says. Hallelujah. Don't fail me not to. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Just want to just share this. Just share a couple of more. Amen. But I want us, amen, to shift our how we acknowledge or how we pray.
Amen.
Thank
you,
Jesus. It's got to shift.
Yeah.
It's got to shift.
Yeah.
We cannot be talking about it. We'll get in prayer. We'll start off strong. And we'll have this, God, listen, God, this is what I'm coming to you. And then we start fussing.
Jesus.
Come on now.
Come on. Be true. How many of y'all have shifted like that?
Amen. 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 Amen.
Then we start talking about it.
Yeah.
From our perspective.
Yeah.
We start talking about it. One of the things that Holy Spirit showed me, he said, take an aerial. And I'm almost finished. He said, take an aerial perspective. He literally showed me I'm flying. Because things that are on ground level, they look big.
Amen.
When they're on ground level. And so when you're flying over specifically areas that you know them houses is 4,000 plus square feet.
Yes.
Now when you're on ground level, you're like, good Lord, them things. Woo, Jesus. Mm-hmm. When you are above it and when you actually take your seat, yeah, amen. It's that the Bible said we're seated in heavenly places, amen.
All right,
from
all
a
right.
different perspective. So when you're actually in an airplane and you're looking down and the things look like small in the bed of my fingernail.
Yes.
How 4,000 square feet look like this big? Because you have taken a different perspective and you're looking at it from a different perspective. Amen. You have now taken an aerial view of what looks big on ground. Why am I saying
all
that?
Right.
Because as long as we're on ground level with things, amen, it looks large, amen, it looks big, it looks like, God, how in the world is this going to be? How in the world?
Right.
This thing is larger than life. But when you literally are seated in heavenly places, amen, and you're looking at this thing from a biblical perspective and what God says about it, what looks large, amen, all of a sudden becomes small and it becomes minute. Why? Because I've changed my perspective.
All right.
I can do that, amen, when I apply the word of God.
Amen.
So we don't go in strong, amen, and end up crying about it. We don't go in, and I'm not saying we don't have sorrow. I'm not saying that we don't have those emotions, amen, because the Bible lets us know we have a high priest. He's touched with all those emotions.
Yes.
All right.
But when I go in, amen, God, you said that you blessed the very fruit of my womb. The fruit of my womb is blessed. So therefore, God, I call a blessing upon them. You said that my children and my children's children would serve you.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. I don't start off and go, oh, God, you did. Oh, Lord, you say, oh, God, help me out, Lord. Lord, this boy, Jesus, he's getting on my nerves. Lord, you got to do something, God. Stay right there and hug that word. Stay right there on that word. Stay right there on that word. Right there on that word. Right there on that word. I had to tell my husband about that one right there. He said, he did like Jed Clampett. I'm loading up the truck and I'm moving. Heels, that is. Black gold. Then the next thing you know, he called us. I'm going to Kentucky. Oh, Lord Jesus. Had to tell his daddy, listen, we're going to declare the word of the Lord.
All right.
Yeah.
You told the London did. In London did. I'm going to sleep.
Yeah.
Call him and ask him, I ain't staying up. Why? Because I done already confessed the word of the Lord over London.
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
I've already confessed the word of the Lord over London.
Amen.
So London can go, London can, hey, I'm moving. So next thing you know, I'm confessing the word of the Lord.
All right.
Therefore, amen. Therefore, that gives me good rest. Because guess what he said? I love this. And I'm just about finished. Listen, Psalm 23, I love the part where it says, for my name's sake.
Yeah.
All right.
Yes.
For his name's sake.
Yeah.
My name is not on the line.
Come on, come on.
All right.
My name is not at stake. Amen. Yeah. At all. God, you said for your name's sake, this is what you're going to do. This is you. This is your endorsement. He's your child. Amen. They're all yours. Amen. Everything concerning all of us belongs to you. And it's you. You already said something great about him. It's great about me. Everybody. Amen. They be like, Mom don't be saying nothing. Mama be in prayer, honey.
Amen.
All right.
Amen.
Oh, Lord Jesus. Listen, get out there for Roko Tara Babasata. Ain't nothing changed, honey. I still get up and walk that floor. Still get up and walk the floor. Hallelujah. Listen, here's my story. Now I'm closing. We lived in Houston. And I would anoint we had a wood floor. I would anoint the bottom of my feet. I got up one day, one time they said, Mom, we couldn't even get out the door to do.
Oh, the power.
And it greasy. Oh, greasy, greasy, greasy. I get up and all I see these little oily footsteps, all I said, Lord have mercy, these folks gonna think I'm crazy. But when I would get up, amen, and start walking, everything in here gonna get right.
All right.
So one day, the oldest one, that's a live wire, amen. And so this one tried to be compliant, so he ain't wanna get no whooping. So anyway, I'm saying this, I'm just throwing this out. So one day I didn't get up. And I would get up every morning, I'd go in the room, I'd be ronco tarada because woo, shadow, everything greasy. The one day I didn't get up. The oldest one, he come at about 14, he come tipping in the house. I said, what's wrong? He said, I was scared, come on. I said, what you scared for? I did not get up. I said, what you scared for? That's the wild card. I said, I was was scared to come on. What you get up for? He said, because you came in the room this morning. I did not get up. He said, you came in the room this morning with them. He said, I was scared. He said, what'd I do? I said, you ain't done nothing. That Holy Ghost, that was not me.
Mercy.
He said, I was scared to come home because that was them tongues that like, who would I do, Jesus? He said, I said, I promise. He said, Mommy, you came in the room. I said, no, I didn't. Not that morning. I really did. I mean, out of all mornings, he coming out. I said, but you scared to come? He said, I'm scared. This will come in, same thing. He's a little softer. So thanks, Mom, for the prayer this morning. I said, I didn't come in your room. He said, yeah, you came into. I said, no, I didn't.
Wow.
He said, yeah. Same Holy Ghost, one of them. You know how the Lord would deal with us, how we need to be dealt with. Every person that runs with, he said, he will rock on their own. This one lives.
Good.
He gets sedated when I pray for him. But here's the thing, amen. God's word gonna prevail.
Amen. Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. Amen. And he hears our cry concerning everything. He literally shamas us. So it does not matter what it is that we're praying. It does not matter, amen, what it is we're praying about. He literally shamas us. He don't just be like, oh, okay, no, I'm coming to see about that, amen. I'm coming to check on that. I'm coming to turn that around, amen. I'm coming to fix that, amen. I'm not just sitting there. He's not that. I'm done. Hallelujah. I stand up all over. Glory to God. He comes to check on us, to see about us, to deliver us. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He don't just listen at us. He shamas us.
My God.
Anywhere you see, hearken and hear and listen. Hallelujah. Literally, I'm telling you, you can put a demand on that thing because it's the word of God. Amen. It's not going to fail. Shema me, O God.
Yes.
Shema us, O God. Hallelujah. With the intent to save. With the very intention to deliver.
Thank you, Jesus.
With the very intention, amen, to pull out. With the very intention, amen, to save and to turn around. So I really want to say today that our prayers are not in vain. Amen. Yes, we go and teach us to pray.